amount of time, is there a typical amount of time it takes for a young man or a young woman to process through the system after they've been arrested? And then what is the likelihood of a repeat arrest after that process has been taken place?
We don't have those specific statistics. Generally, an arrest can take a couple hours to, a couple days in order to process. It depends on when you're arrested, what you're,
I was all right with you explaining this, because Sima does an excellent job of explaining this, but she's right. It depends on what you're arrested for, what day of the week, what time, and all of that. You know, we have something in the district called the lively decision that says that you have to, if from the time you're arrested, you have 3 hours to be presented to a magistrate or a judge for arraignment. And so the law plays in an important role in that. But if you get arrested on Friday night or Saturday, there's no court on Sunday, so you end up being in the central cell block until Monday. So it all depends on what it is. The frequency of arrest, though, rears its ugly head in the report, because police know where to go to arrest people for drugs. And so those areas, there's a couple of things taking place. Racial profiling, number one, and then also they're targeting black areas. The Pastor Lamar raised a real critical point. He talked about where we smoke marijuana. Well, we don't really smoke marijuana standing on the corner, because you can't really tell that it's marijuana. But the police, up until a couple of months ago, would come up and say, "You smell like you've been smoking marijuana." And that was his interpretation, or hers. It wouldn't have been necessarily true. But if he says that, then the move was to place you on the arrest, because he could use that as probable cause to make the arrest. And so we've been seeing those kind of things all along. You can go back to the 80s around the Operation Clean Sweep that took place in our city, where we saw 53,000 people arrested over a 6 to 7 month period of time. But when you strip back the thin veneer of all of those arrests, you can see that there were people who were arrested over repeatedly, because if you live in Condon Terrace, where are you going to stand but in Condon Terrace? And they weren't necessarily being arrested for crack, which that's what Operation Clean Sweep was about. What they were being arrested for, and over 3/4 of the arrests, had to do with urinating in public, drinking in public, driving after revocation, driving with no permit, driving with tickets, and all those kind of things. So 3/4 of the arrests had nothing to do with crack, but it was a political statement so that the person who was running for mayor at that particular time could claim that he cleaned up the community. And yet, all it really did was ball up and tie down our criminal justice system. And the ceiling that was put on the jail occurred right after that, because our jail was overflowing because of the 53,000 people that had been pushed into the pipeline that didn't have anything to do with the political theme of that time. And that was, we was doing something about crack. But we really wasn't doing anything about crack. It was another example of the war on drugs that was a miserable failure and hasn't done anything other than been a war on black people. And I know that was a long answer, but that was the whole thing in a nutshell.